My quads! My quads! My quads! Lower the cage!
A fucking six man Hell in a Cell. Like, I know they did one.
Yes, yeah, one was.
Yeah, but that was mental, like.
Yeah. I think they did a couple of them, actually. Because I remember, like, that was, like, their proto Elimination Chamber before they, you know, got to the.
I don't think they ever did a six man after the one in 2000.
2001.
I'm just double checking now. Yeah.
No, 2000.
No, 2000.
Yeah, Armageddon 2000.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Yeah, I forgot the fucking time jump.
The only reason I knew that is because I only watched it recently.
Yeah.
Actually, I wonder. Here's a question. Do you think you'll get? Do you think with the new regime we'll get team sets again?
I'd like to say yes, but I do think it's a cost-cutting thing, and they probably will not bother. Which is a shame because they're like they add so much to the shows.
Just for pay-per-views, that's all. Just for pay-per-views.
Yeah, it'd be great. I totally agree. But no, they won't bother. They're lazy. And what a spectacle this whole promotion of Raw and SmackDown is going to be. But can they get along? Raw and SmackDown superstars trying to survive Hell in a Cell match for the World Heavyweight title. That's all. I don't agree with you, Jared.
I always find it funny that, like, they're really playing it up as if, like, there's only one fucking title when there's two on the go.
Well, this is where it does get confusing, because, like, if a SmackDown superstar wins this six-man match, do they take the title over to SmackDown? This is a bit of a plot hole, I'll be honest.
Edge, Cena, Rey Mysterio, Shawn Michaels, Triple H, and Christian again.
Christian!
Oh, fuck off, Christian.
Yeah, apparently he's third billing on Raw. Who knew? Apparently everyone else on Raw can just fuck off, apparently. All the big boys are on SmackDown, apparently.
Oh, what was his name?
Lance Cade. Or Garrison Cade, indeed. Survivor Series didn't draw a crowd, lads, did it? Jesus.
No, God, it really didn't.
It's a bit empty in here.
It's kind of like last week's SummerSlam. Oh, this is mental.
Yeah.
Going straight for the fucking chair.
Oh no, I'm not.
The door.
Yes.
I'm trying to get the fuck out of here.
I'm also trying to bring someone with me. You see, whenever we did have a six-man Hell in a Cell match in these games, it was always the pinfall has to happen in the ring. But there's a critical difference in this version. Pinfalls can happen anywhere.
Okay, so good El Rey. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God, they're all out. Oh, God, it's like insects.
Yeah. The zoom out is strong with this one. Oh, Cena's gone. Boom.
Oh shit.
And Christian. And Triple H. This is just like a really like stressful scaffold match, isn't it? It's like, oh, and he fell, he's eliminated. Oh, and he fell, he's eliminated. And this is where I learned, oh, okay, pinfalls are now a thing anywhere. This is concerning. I have no chance of winning.
I wonder who did the mocap for the fucking the cell phone.
Like, good question. I'd love to know myself. I know for a long time it was actually one Nick Nemeth who did all the selling for the or the motion capture for the wrestling games.
Mm.
I believe Kingston, Kofi Kingston had a stint for a while as well. And another person that's on the tip of my tongue that I can't remember. Maybe Evan Bourne? Could be wrong.
Perhaps.
Perhaps. Whoa.
Oh!
Now, it's
nasty.
Beautiful.
Three is in a row.
Gas. Absolutely gas. Ah, okay, there's some answers. Smackdown vs. Raw, 2011. Aaron Aguilera did the Undertaker and Big Show motion capture. Paul London did Evan Bourne and Kofi Kingston. Austin Aries did Santino Marella, Chris Jericho, and Evan Bourne. And Claudio Castagnoli did Edge and Jack Swagger. Apparently, Cole Cabana also did Triple H and MVP mocap. There you go.
Interesting.
Yeah.
It's a strange selection of people.
It is. They were using indie stars instead of actual contracted people. I should actually look at the credits when we get to the end of this game and see if we recognize any shoot names. Then that'll explain who did them or who not.
Yeah. It's really weird looking at the crowd that there actually is seats. It's so strange.
Very strange. Yeah, it's like the seats are there, but the actual the people are 2D.
Yeah,
it's weird. Like how No Mercy used to look.
How the hell do you win this match? Like, Jesus Christ.
It's dumb luck. Quite honestly, dumb luck. Either that or you focus on the weakest person, meld them in finishers, throw them off the cell a few times, and then just, pick up a cheap win. Ow. Fucking Shawn Michaels is a shit to answer this.
Yeah. Triple H is in bits.
Yeah. So you want to focus on Triple H here, he thinks.
Triple H or Rey Mysterio?
Yeah.
Oh, and that was right in the middle of the thing as well.
Yeah.
Motherfucker.
Yeah, I know.
If that pin was close, going on, he probably would have.
Yeah. Oh,
someone's pinning. Oh, it's over.
It's over.
Mysterio
won.
Rey Mysterio won. Yeah.
Oh, and he was the one who was actually beat up the most.
Yes. You never rule out the underdog, clearly.
Well, I can't believe it, but it's a fact. A SmackDown superstar survived to be our Raw champion here today.
Look how devastated he is.
It's a dark day. He didn't even pin the champion.
Yeah.
Raw still keeps the title.
Yeah. By the way, this is for our world championship, but it only counts as a title to change if a Raw superstar wins. If it was SmackDown, no. Tough fits. You don't get it. Which I think is hilarious. So there you go. That was a bit of a damn scuba match. Oh, SmackDown got lost. Good night, everybody. We'll see you next week. But now the question is, what happens next? January, week one. Do you know what happens in January, lads? It's Rumble season.
Ooh.
Of course, the game had to figure out a way to get the belt off you, so you have to compete in it.
Ah, no, and we actually are still champion here. Because, what? Mysterio didn't win the championship.
I don't understand that.
It needed a why. Because it was a six-man tag for the six-man match for the world championship. But the SmackDown guy won, as in Cena or Mysterio, they just win the match. They don't win the title. But if one of the Raw lads did, then they'd be champion. So now we're still holding our belts.
So
the computer said no.
Pretty much, yeah. The computer wasn't able to.
No, we didn't. No, it's not that. It's computer says no.
He says no. Mid and now. But there we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are less than 4 weeks away from the Royal Rumble, a co-production of Raw and SmackDown.
And we will encourage you not to mention the previous co-production, which ended with a really bullshit main event.
Right here will defend his World Heavyweight title belt at the pay-per-view.
He said belt.
He did.
Champ, I'm putting you in a non-title single match tonight to make sure that you're in shape for...
Oh! A new challenger appears. And he thinks he's cute.
And he looks like a who. Look, he does.
He does. Oh, he looks like he made a fair point.
I've got a problem with you calling that title his championship.
Thank you, Shawn Michaels, for voice acting.
He couldn't beat me in a one-on-one. I deserve a title match for his championship at the Royal Rumble.
Thank you. Someone
Listen,
who knows
I
how to act.
Show around here, not you. If you want a title shot, you'll have to earn it like every other guy in the locker room.
No offense, legend Shawn Michaels.
Bischoff, you're full of it. You can't get away with ignoring a superstar like me. You better remember that Raw isn't the only brand in town.
Ooh.
Raw isn't the only brand in town. What do you mean by that?
Yes, I wonder what could be the mystery.
Hey, what do you
of
fucking think?
It could be anything, lads. It could be anything. We may never know. So let's move on.
There's Velocity.
He's going. He's going to Sunday Night Heat. Oh, hey, Rhino. Remember him? Your favorite boy, Jerry.
Yeah, I like Rhino.
Yeah. One of the failed candidates for this Mirror Universe so far.
That's right.
Ooh. Yeah. Maybe one day we'll play as Rhino. I don't think he ran for governor. Like, when you look at this guy, you're thinking, yeah, he can be a Republican politician. I can believe him as a senator.
I used to love his music.
Yes. Good music. Good music. Man. I could Jeff Cobb off him, actually, in this PS2 version. As Foxy pours popcorn over himself. Make it rain. Now we got plenty of challengers now. Rhino, Shawn Michaels, they're both more or less at the same level, so you know. Yes, that look of despair was exactly what I was expecting for saying something like that.
Yeah.
Folks, I hope you can hear us over the roar of this capacity crowd.
Excellent.
It's just about time to go here.
Excellent.
And business is about to pick up.
Yeah, not to mention ratings. I don't get it, but the fans just can't get enough of it.
I wouldn't take that edge. Ooh.
You just know some of these competitors have studied each other very carefully. You'll never see action like this on SmackDown.
Of course, these lads know each other like superbly well because they're in the group trained together from Canada. Yeah.
Yeah, they work the indies together.
Yeah.
So it was Edge and Christian that gave him the name Rhino.
That is true, yes.
Was it? Yeah.
Yeah.
It was just on one of their tours. On their travels in Canada, like they were doing, like they're going to like to the most northern part, like an RSN place.
Mm.
But like, yeah, at one point, like they just something happened, and that's where they gave him the name. Because like he was just like a tree trunk of a guy. You've seen him, you know. Yeah. And it's scary.
Yeah. Like, it's actually scary seeing him in the ring in person.
Yeah.
The legs alone. Like, Jesus, I've never seen anyone's legs the way
yeah.
his legs. Like, fucking hell.
His legs were bigger than my fucking body, and I'm like, what the fuck?
And you're a fat fuck. That's unbelievable.
I know. Fucking hell.
You had to get that one in, Jared, didn't you? You had to get that one.
I had to. Now, come here, listen. I can't fucking say anything. I'm a big fat fuck as well, so.
Indeed, we are all taking turns of being the fat bastard in the room.
No, you're just a prick.
Oh, fair enough. But hey, if I'm not a fat prick, then that's an improvement. My favorite thing about Rhino is how much of a germaphobe he was. Because famously, like, he wouldn't shake anyone's hand. He'd use the fist bump.
Mm-hmm.
To the point where, like, wow, he actually did see COVID coming. He knew. He could tell.
He was in the inner circle.
He was. He is the top inner circle.
He is COVID. Think about it.
Love it.
Rope break.
I think I do make an effort of showing Edge's submission moves in this match, because I know he does have a pretty decent execution, I think it is, in his move pool, and I was trying to basically find it.
Education.
It's Educator, yes. There it is there.
Hmm.
Very effective, I must say, especially considering his moveset kind of focuses on the back anyway, so.
Yeah, that was the kind of handy thing, like, Edge actually had a moveset that complemented what kind of finishers he was using.
Mm.
Whereas, yes. Like, a lot of people nowadays just do moves for the sake of it.
Kind of, yeah.
Like, there's no real setup or rhyme or reason for it.
Actually, that's a very good point. There's very few people that do setup moves anymore. You know, like the one that always comes to mind is the knee drop that Triple H does to loop into Pedigree. You know, very simple and straightforward, but it's just so flowing. You know, when Orton was starting to do his RKO stuff, he'd have the inverted back, the backbreaker, that leads into someone coming up for the RKO, like. Just simple stuff like that, like, it just works so well, you know.
But it was also like, you would have his backbreaker, which if you really want, actually, sorry, The Miz had a good one, where it was backbreaker and then into a reverse DDT,
yeah,
or neckbreaker. Mm. He had that, like, a combo move.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go again. Will he tap out? That's the burning question here. Beautiful. You ever seen a rhino tap? Yeah, once.
You ever see a rhino give birth to a human?
Yeah, once.
Yeah.
What a strange artifact now when you look back at that movie. It's not as bad as the first movie, as in outdated, but the second movie still has moments.
I really like the second movie.
Yeah, second movie is much better. Oh, hello. Whose legs are dead? Oh, Sean Michaels. Oh, look, yeah, he's using a cell phone. Next week.
That's right, like we talked about before.
I'm sorry, I have to end this conversation. I'm on camera.
Great. Thanks a lot. Oh. Really appreciate it, Kurt.
Ooh. Ooh.
Is he actually asking Kurt Angle for help? That can't be it, JR. There's got to be another explanation.
No. Nope. No, that is actually why.
Well, if there is, King, I can't come up with it.
Therefore, I'm going to be disgusted for the entire day. I've been playing this game for the duration of this playthrough. It did make me very reminiscent of the actual good soundtracks they had in these games.
Mm-hmm.
rather than the shite put on them now. Now, let's see what happens next. Will the defector be draw? Will they draw attention to the defector, or will there be developments? That was an extravagant amount of pyro for a Raw. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Monday Night Raw. I'm good old JR Jim Ross here with Jerry, the King Lawler. And what a kickoff we've got tonight, King.
You got that right, JR. We're going to find out who the number one contender will be for the World Heavyweight Championship at the Royal Rumble.
Uh-huh.
And that,
that seems important. So let's see.
What was always funny is that like they weren't afraid to just reuse assets, like to the point where like they didn't even change JR or fucking like King
for years. Yeah,
years. Like,
hey, we know him. We gave him 2 good years and shut him out.
True.
Oh. The saddest 3 count you'll ever hear.
Yeah.
How could this have happened?
It looks like Earl Hebner, but it's not Earl Hebner. So therefore, we don't have to pay Earl Hebner.
I'm not the real Earl Hebner. I'm Derek Hebner. Yes.
That is actually fucking true. Like the.
Yeah.
No, his name is Herl Ebner.
Herl Ebner, yes.
Herl Ebner.
Oh, hang on. Michelle was on the phone here.
Well, you see, Eric, you haven't done such a good job of keeping your superstars happy.
I do apologize for skipping dialogue.
One of your unhappiest superstars is the man who just won the last match. Now, we both know that his contract is up right after WrestleMania, and he's your new number one contender.
Oh no, shenanigans again.
Oh, so they did the fucking the CM Punk storyline like back in 2004?
Yes, but instead of going to the indies, it's going to somewhere so much worse. Smackdown. Where we work on Tuesdays instead of Mondays.
I'm like Triple H, who didn't want to work Tuesdays.
Ah, oh, what a beautiful line that was.
What a promo.
Matt freaking Hardy.
I have to wonder how much of this did he actually kind of tell people about?
Nah, no, those lads were genuinely out of the blue. They actually came in drunk. Like, JBL was, like, legit, like, hammered for the show. So much so that on the original One Night Stand DVD, there's live commentary of JBL for the entire thing, and he's mic'd over the whole thing. And he just, like, hurls, like, serious amounts of abuse at people. Like, homophobic and shit like that. And right beside him was Orlando Jordan, who, of course, comes out as bi a couple of years later.
My question is, okay, like, Edge is just after hitting Eddie Guerrero. Why is he after?
Because he's in on it. We're getting back on SmackDown, Foxy. Come on, SmackDown are the enemy.
Come on, it's Herl Ebner. You know
it's
what I mean?
Herl Ebner, exactly.
Herl Ebner. He's just
cool. That guy will fucking, like, you know, will suck you off for a pack of quavers, like, you know? Like, he will do anything for money.
Jim Ross here with Jerry the King Law. And tonight, JR, these thousands of fans here in the arena and the millions watching at home.
You're getting Jerry, fucking worse this
way. Jerry, Jerry, you good?
I can't remember the last time I looked forward to a match as much as I'm looking forward to.
I did love these backstage part brawl things, because when you whip someone into something, just like match it happens. Like I think it was in some of the later games where like if you like archive someone into like a closet or something like that, the boogeyman appears.
Mm-hmm.
Which is this great crack, like, I thought those damage, like.
Oh,
Oh. Boom.
Swing, bada, 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 bada.
Swing, bada, bada, fucking swing.
Jesus Christ.